It's been about a month since my last Universal Credit video, and since then there's been a number of changes that could affect your Universal Credit entitlement or payments, whether you're a new claimant or an existing one. So in this video we'll hear from the DWP and the courts on a number of changes that could affect your benefits payments and could be implemented within the next month. So let's get right into it. Over 120,000 Universal Credit claimants are currently believed to be repaying court fines. This includes those fines issued for begging under the 1824 Vagrancy Act. For people on Universal Credit, court fine repayments are usually taken automatically out of their Universal Credit payments. Usually this is done by way of a blanket 30% fixed reduction. And with a benefit system that leaves many struggling to survive, even with their full entitlement, these reductions are leaving thousands of people in a very vulnerable situation where they can't even afford to meet the cost of living. All of this was brought to light in a recent court case. The housing charity Shelter brought this case to the courts after a number of rough sleepers that have moved into their settled housing were still struggling to keep on top of their expenses due to the high deductions from their payments. The case focused on four former rough sleepers in Manchester who were left with just £52 per week to cover the cost of food, heating, transport, job interviews, medical appointments and more. And all of this was because the Department of Work and Pensions were deducting a third of their payments to cover court fines. The Department of Work and Pensions policy required deductions to be imposed at a fixed 30% rate, regardless of their personal situation. The judge in the High Court ruled in favour of the four men and said that the department was in breach of a law requiring benefits officials to use their discretion to ensure court fines were deducted from Universal Credit at a rate recognising clients' vulnerability and ability to repay. The judge also agreed that the fixed deduction rate ran contrary to a 1992 law, which requires benefits officials to use discretion when deciding the amount that they deduct for court fine repayments, which can actually range from a minimum of 5% up to a maximum of 30%. This new ruling means that from now, any Universal Credit claimants that are facing financial difficulty, and not just if you're homeless, can contact the DWP and ask them to reduce the level of deductions to make sure that you're not left in a financially vulnerable position. Before we go on to the next one, if you find this video useful, please give it a like because it really helps out the channel. And I just wanted to say a massive thank you for almost hitting 650 subscribers. This channel's growing so much faster than I ever thought. And as a thank you, I'm going to be doing a giveaway as we approach 1,000 subscribers. So if you're not already subscribed, make sure you do so you don't miss that announcement. The next change is one that will affect people who claim Universal Credit, personal independence payments, or employment support allowance. Since the beginning of the pandemic in March 2020, all in-person appointments were cancelled and were replaced by either telephone or paper-based appointments. This has made it a lot easier for claimants, especially those who are disabled, those that would have to travel quite far to get to the job centre, and also for those who are at high risk or even just worried about COVID during these times. However, with the government starting to ease lockdown restrictions, the Department of Work and Pensions has announced that face-to-face assessments will restart for some claimants. In a statement, the DWP said, initially this will only be for those who are unable to be fully assessed by other channels, and that people will be invited for their appointments by letter, which will clearly set out what to expect at their appointment. Face-to-face assessments will now take place alongside the existing paper-based and telephone-based appointments. This is both for PIP and Work Capability Assessments for ESA and Universal Credit claimants. Alongside this, a legislation came into effect on the 25th of March 2021, which means video call assessments are now being rolled out across the UK. So if you're currently claiming or planning on claiming Universal Credit or any of the other benefits mentioned, it's important to remember that the DWP have a history of heavy sanctions for missed appointments, especially for those without a valid reason or without you letting them know beforehand. So it's important that you keep logging in to check your Universal Credit account and keep an eye out for any letters regarding the DWP, as it could be a letter to inform you about a face-to-face meeting and you want to make sure that you don't miss it. The next update is regarding the £20 per week uplift. At the start of the pandemic last year in 2020, Universal Credit claimants were given a £20 per week uplift to help ease the burden of the lockdowns and the global pandemic. However, this did cause some controversy as over 1.9 million employment support allowance claimants and also disability benefits claimants were not eligible for this uplift. Two ESA claimants are now challenging this decision, and the High Court has given them permission to now challenge the DWP over its failure to offer this £20 per week uplift to those on legacy benefits as well as the Universal Credit claimants. The claimants are arguing that the DWP's decision is discriminatory and unjust. A DWP spokesperson said in a statement, "It has always been the case that claimants on legacy benefits can make a claim for Universal Credit if they believe that they will be better off." So with DWP surprisingly arguing that they've done nothing wrong, it's now up to the courts to decide if they've breached the European Convention of Human Rights by only giving the uplift to Universal Credit claimants and not those on legacy benefits. If the court finds that that is the case, those on legacy benefits could begin getting that £20 per week uplift, as well as receiving a backdated payment for all of the weeks that they've missed. As soon as a decision's been made in this case, I'll make a video about it, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that one. And to watch more videos on Universal Credit, check out these videos here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.